हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज विवेक वैभव एंड यू आर वाचिंग लेक्चर वीडियो ऑन रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ ज्योग्राफिकल फीचर्स थ्रू कंटूर्स, क्लास 8 ज्योग्राफी। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू आर डूइंग वेल एट योर होम। इन द लास्ट वीडियो लेक्चर वी हैव लर्न्ड व्हाट इज कंटूर लाइंस, what is slope, contour intervals, and basic knowledge of benchmark, support height, triangulated height, and contour lines, steep slope and gentle slope. Now, we are going to discuss today cliff and the different types of landscape through contoured lines. Dear students, first and foremost, I want to deal cliff. It is your question and today I am going to deal. Cliff is a vertical or near vertical rock face. It is abrupt change of the land on top of sheet. Cliff are shown by contoured lines that are very close together and in some instance merge into a single lines like that. You know that this is cliff. As you see in this picture, these contour lines definitely very nearer, very close to each other, and the landscape you see in this picture is definitely a rock face structure, and actually it is a cliff. Okay, now we are going to discuss conical hills. Conical hills, as you know that a conical hill is represented by equal spacing contour and heights increasing towards the central circular contours. Contour appears in concentric circles and the slope are equal to all directions. The central or the innermost contour has highest value showing summit of hills. As you seen in this picture, this is conical in shape landscape, and here we have contour line. So in your topographical sheet, when you see like this quagmire structure in a one, basically in the center we have the greater height value of contour lines. Okay, so this is the maximum height of contour, 2200 meter, and this is the lowest 1500, which is pedamount of the foot hills. This is the foot hills. Okay, a conical hills with uniform slope and narrow top represented concentric contours spaced almost at regular interval. This is the conical hills. Now, in another picture, you have seen quagmire structure like that, and you have already seen in the last two picture. Now, plateau. As you know that plateau is a tabletop flatted land. So plateau is a flat top and the steep edge highlands. The innermost contour, highest contour, is very wide. The represent of flat table like top, and there is may have closely spaced contour that depict steep slopes, as you have seen in this picture. Like this, you have tabletop land. This is something table like a structure. In the top, this is very linear type of structure, linear lines type of structure. That means it is a plain surface area, and from here to here, it is definitely increasing in the height way, and from here it is constant, and from here to here it decreases. Like that, this is the landscape and this is contour lines. It is also plateau. Now, the major part of your landscape. My dear students, there are many mountain range in the world and having different set of structure and different set of things we have seen, and repeatedly when you visit that place, we seen different set of landscape. So how can you find in your topographical sheet is very pertinent question today. Now, ridge, saddle, col, gap and pass. First, we are going to deal with ridge. Ridge is a long narrow shape as upland with several peaks. It is also a range of hills. The slope may be steep or may be gentle. As you have seen in this picture, this is ridge. Okay. Now, this is contour of ridge. So, contour of ridge like that. We, if you see in this topo sheet, we have this sorts of structure. Okay. In a contour lines. In a middle. And as you know that in the middle, highest contour lines given. And in the outer of the contour lines, outermost contour lines is the lowest height of the contours, as you have seen each and every contours. Now, so you have easily recognized ridge in your topocit. Now, saddle. Saddle is a shallow depression between two hills. Depression means deep point in comparison to hills in any area. It is bordered gap compared to col. A saddle is also because it resembles the shape of saddle used on horses. As you know that in a horses, when horse rider climb on it, definitely in a horse back there is the saddle. So then, like saddle like a structure when you found in a mountain range is definitely called saddle. It does not provide passes through mountain. Look at this picture. This is, isn't it like saddle of horse? And the structure of the contour lines in your topographical sheet like that. Okay. This is saddle, saddle-like structure. Okay. Now col. A col is also sometimes called saddle. It is like saddle-like structure, but it a low point between two hills or between two peaks of a ridge. Okay. And if the gap is wide, then it is known as saddle. So, in this contour, if the gap is not wider, we can say it col. Okay. So, like this structure we have, this is col and this is saddle. Okay. This is gap and this is pass. Now, pass. As you have seen in this picture, we have pass. So, two conical hills like a structure and a two or three contour lines passes outer surface of this conical hills like a structure, as you have seen in this sheet. So you easily find out in your topographical sheet. A pass is a lowland between two mountain peaks and provides a passes. As you know that in Himalayas there are so many passes: Nathula Pass, Shivkila Pass, Jorjila Pass, like that. So, passes like a structure is this. Passes between two mountain ranges, there is the way to go another places is passes. Now, gap. A gap is a low-lying depression or valley which cuts through a range of hills. A river is flowing through a gap. Definitely, a river is flowing like this. This is the gap we have. This is the gap. And look at this blue lines. It shows river. Okay. So, if you cut a conical hills in a three side, into two parts, three side contours line, conical contours, and one small water bodies or river flowing through it. This is gap. So all this is all about your landscape, ridge, saddle, col, and passes. I hope you enjoy this video and understood easily conical hills, plateau, cliff, all the things. So keep watching my video, and if you have any doubt, just write in a comment on YouTube also and in your classroom also. Okay, thank you so much. Stay tuned.